السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. ما شاء الله رمضان مبارك to all the children out there. ما شاء الله تبارك الله. I am so excited to be allowed to see this month of Ramadan. We actually got to the first fast. Remember there was a time when we were saying last month and the month before that Ramadan is going to come very soon. It's going to come very soon. Guess what? It's here already. We're started. The first fast in most parts of the world. Subhanallah. Now, why do people have different days of fasting? You mustn't worry too much about that, because if they did not see the moon, they won't fast. And if they saw the moon, then they will fast. And sometimes, if they're following another country, they may fast with that country. And sometimes, if they're not following any country and they're doing it themselves, then they will do it that way. So it's not a big problem. It does not mean that I don't like you or I don't love you if I don't fast on the same day as you, or if I don't have Eid on the same day as you. That's point number one, because many children have asked me, why do Muslims sometimes not fast on the same day? Well, I'd love them to, but you know, it's okay, it's fine. If you didn't see the moon, that's you, subhanallah. Now, my beloved children, I'm so excited to have embarked on this journey of giving you a short lesson and a little bit of something to take back, to think about every day, inshallah. So the first thing I said was about the moon and why people have differences. I've given you a simple explanation. Now, what is the month of Ramadan? The month of Ramadan is a gift from Allah. It's a month wherein which Muslims become more conscious of many things. Firstly, they don't eat and drink during the daylight hours, from what is known as dawn to dusk. Dawn is the beginning time of the first prayer known as Fajr. So you know there are five prayers in the day. Fajr, which is before sunrise. Dhuhr, which is just after the zenith, early afternoon. Asr is late afternoon. Then we have Maghrib, which is immediately after sunset. And we have Isha, which is a little bit after that, like perhaps 1.5 to 2 hours after sunset in most cases. So it's the late night prayer. So the fasting starts right at the beginning. Subhanallah, the fasting starts at the beginning before Fajr. When the Adhan of Fajr goes, you stop eating. Subhanallah, you stop drinking. Subhanallah, for the sake of Allah. And it's good to get up very early before that and have a small meal, a little meal that's full of that which is rich in many nutrients and perhaps what is called low GI. That means, you know, you have grains and things that digest slowly through the day. A banana is good. I usually have a few dates, a banana, a little bit of milk, maybe oats sometimes, and a cup of tea with some water. And I don't have so much, because if I eat a lot in that early meal known as suhoor, some people call it sehri. So either way, if I eat a lot, I feel hungry very quickly because my stomach starts working with all the enzymes and everything's trying to digest what's happening. So I feel hungry very early. So I just have a light meal at that time. And then subhanallah, you do your Salatul Fajr and you might want to go to bed depending on where you are for a little while. You might have school to go to, and you must be a better person in Ramadan. So we stay away from food and drink and from bad language from dawn to dusk. Dusk is when the sun sets. As soon as the sun disappears, you can eat. إِذَا أَقْبَلَ اللَّيْلُ مِنْهَا هُنَا وَأَدْبَرَ النَّهَارُ مِنْهَا هُنَا فَقَدْ أَفْطَرَ الصَّائِمُ. The Prophet ﷺ says, when the nightfall, you know, when the day disappears and the night comes up, then the fast is ended, or the one who is fasting can actually break that fast. So this was just a quick lesson that I thought I'd give you today. You now know why people fast on different days sometimes. It doesn't mean we don't love each other. It does not mean we don't respect each other. It's okay to have a difference of opinion sometimes, for as long as the Prophet ﷺ has taught them both, or has taught it in a way that you can interpret it in more than one way. That's fine. So alhamdulillah. My dear children, I will join you again tomorrow with a beautiful message, a little bit more about the month of Ramadan. In the meantime, try your best to fast. I think I want to talk about those details and I want to say everything today, but let's leave it for tomorrow. We try our best to fast. We try our best at this stage to watch our mouths and be careful of what we say. And inshallah, we meet again tomorrow. Until then, I love you guys. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.